Hi there, and welcome to Scrap and Coffee. It's time to start on a new project. So, as you can see, I've got a bunch of stuff lying here, and it's all from the Home Again collection by Cartabella. And when I saw this collection, I just fell in love, and I went crazy and bought all sorts of stuff from the collection to make a mini album. The collection is designed by Jen Allison, and she did an amazing job. This is so beautiful. I really love it, and I cannot wait to use it and decorate it with it. But first, we need to make an album. So I've got a bunch of stuff. In the first place, I just bought one paper pack, and I bought some extra sheets to go along with the designs that I really love because I thought one paper pack might not be enough. And then still, when I had this, I was like, no, this is still not enough. So I bought a second paper pack. So I have two paper packs with the pattern paper and the sticker sheets. I've got some extra sheets, and I have the coordinating solid paper pack, so we can use that as well. Also, I've got some extra stuff. So I have the chipboard stickers, chipboard accents. I have the animal dots. I have the Amphera pack. And I also got these designer dies. Now, of course, you don't have to use this with this paper collection. You can use it with everything, but I just really liked them when I saw it, and I want to use them in the album as well. So that's why they are here as well. Also, I'm using not a black for my base on the album. I'm going to use this. It's stone green. It's from the paper mill store. It's an 80-pound smooth cardstock. So a little bit out of my comfort zone, but this is what I'm going to use for the base of the album. So, yeah, I cannot wait. So, yeah, let's get to it. Okay, let's get to it. I've prepared some pieces. Normally, I would make my cover first or start with making my pages. But this time, I'm going to start a little bit different because I have this idea in my head for the cover and I have to make a piece for it. And that's what we're going to start with because when that's done, I have to measure it, and then that's going to determine the actual size of my cover pieces. Now, it's not, I know what the sizes need to be, but yeah, it's possible that because of this piece, I need to adjust it a little bit. So what I did is I have two pieces of chipboard, and I have a piece of, I think this is called poster board or something. It's like a thicker foam, and I'm going to use it to get some height. So all the pieces have the same measurements, and all have the same measurement window in there. And I just got that with my craft knife, just measured everything out. And I am going to make a sort of sandwich with this. So I have a piece of chipboard, the poster board, and then again a piece of chipboard. And I'm going to glue it all together. And then I'm going to use some strips to make it a little bit more neat on the edges. And then I'm going to cover it in a pattern paper as well. So if you think like, oh, those with the strips, that's just too much of a fuss for me, you can skip it, but I just want to make sure that everything looks nice and neat as best as I can get it. So I'm going over some extra steps for that. So let's first make the sandwich. I'm going to combine double-sided tape with some wet glue for this, so I can have a little bit of wiggling room as well. Adding some wet glue. I'm just giving all of that a little burnish. So let's see. Cutting the poster board was actually pretty easy. I didn't know at forehand if it was gonna be easy, but it was. Also, I just bought it at my local dollar store. It was like maybe $1.50 Canadian dollar. I'm not sure anymore, but it's not expensive at all. And it just gives me the depth. You could use it for your shakers if you want. So I'm going to apply some wet glue as well. Let's see. I'm just going over the double-sided tape. So I keep my wiggle room. Like this. And I'm going to do that here as well. And I will add a little extra in between. And now I'm going to place this on there as good as I can. Try to line it up. And the most important thing to me is that the foam, the poster board, is not going over the chipboard. That's my outside edge. See, in the middle I'm fine as well. So the only thing with the poster board is, you can see it here, don't fuss around too much with it. Just make your cut, and here I tried to do too much. So that's also why I am using the chipboard, because I just want to have that sturdiness in there as well. You could do it without if you want. So I'm going to apply the other piece of chipboard the same way on top of that. Okay, so that sandwich is made. It's nice and thick. It's about, I think, 1/4 inch in thickness. Yeah, 1/4 inch. So, yeah, nice and thick, nice and sturdy. So now I'm going to work with the strips. And I've got some strips in black, because that's just, you're not going to be able to see it. And I also have one in the stone green. That's the base that I'm going to use for the album. I'm going to place those on the inside of the frame, because when I did my tryout, I realized that I'm not going to be able to cover up the corners completely with the pattern paper. So I figured if I'm going to see what's underneath there, I want it to be the base and not black or anything else. So I'm just going to place those on the inside frame. I'm going to do the black on the outside. Of course, you can just use whatever you're using, and that doesn't really matter. So I'm going to start with the outside. So what I did is, I've got strips and I've made 2 score lines that are 1/4 inch apart from each other, and I'm going to fold that over the outside edge. Now I'm going to use this one because I've tried it out a little bit, so I can place this over here. So I just placed some double-sided tape on the bumpy side of that strip, and I'm going to give it a burnish and then remove it, the tape backing. And then I'm going to place, and now I have to be a little bit careful because I already have that crease there. So I'm placing it on top of here with that my score lines on the outside of the piece, and I'm going to burnish it a little bit and then fold it to the end. Now this is one of those steps where you might say, no, I'm not going to do this. That's fine, of course. And now I am going to taper this a little bit to get rid of the bulk. On both sides, of course. And then I can just go to the other edge. Try to keep your score lines on the edge of the... Maybe this way is easy. You cannot see what I'm doing, but I'm just making sure that I'm having my score lines on the chipboard. And then we can fold this inwards as well. Put it here, and it's just to get rid of the bulk. It doesn't matter if you're if not completely perfect because you will be covering it up eventually, but you don't want to have too much bulk on your corners. And then burnish the sides. So this is what I will do all around. And I will, the next piece, I'm just going to bump it up to the first piece. You don't need any overlapping or anything. It's just, that will only give you bulk. So if you're using a different material, I suggest you just measure the width of this piece, and that's the space you want to have in between your score lines. So again, I'm making sure the chipboard is on the score lines. Give it a burnish, and now I just think it's a little bit easier to first taper it and then fold it. You see, I learn as I go. That's just how it works. And okay, now let's fold this again. So far, so good. So, last one. Now I am going to measure there. So I'm just eyeballing how far I want it, and I'm going to cut it a little bit longer. I can always make it a little bit shorter. I think that's just fine, actually. Nice. That already looks so good. Okay, so that's the outside in the black. Now we have to do the inside, and that's going to be a little bit more tricky, I'm guessing. I am going to start again in the middle. Yeah. Okay. Just giving that a quick burnish. So we are just taking our time. I have a little bit of tape overhanging on these strips, but that doesn't matter too much. It's going to be covered up. And just again, and now we just have to fuzz around a little bit. Again, we want to have that score lines on top of the chipboard. Oh, okay, how are we going to do this? See, I am struggling just as much as everybody else is probably, I hope. Okay. I don't know if you're able to see what I'm doing, but I'm trying to guide my score lines on the chipboard. And then we have to really get it in the corner as well. So I'm just giving that a good burnish. Try to say on your chipboard with your score lines. Really make that fold into that corner. You really want to have it in there. And then the last one. And I think I'm going to cut this strip a little shorter because I don't want to go too far in the... too close to the corner at the end. And now we are going to taper again. So I'm just doing one side first. And then I am going to leave those on. Oh, just pull it off. That's not a big deal. Just folding sides now, but just from on one side only, and making those score lines at forehand just really, really help on making those folds at this stage. Didn't went very good in that corner, so that's something you really have to watch. Take your time on it, because I didn't do the most awesome job, but I don't really mind it either, but it could have been better. I also don't think we need to don't fuss around too much with it, because we don't want our paper to crack either. So I am not measuring it. I'm just going to remove the tape backing parsley from this one. And I'm going to start over here, I think. So again, just making that first beginning is can be a bit difficult. And I'm going to get this one in here. Hopefully that went a little bit better. See this? That's not a big deal. So, that turned out quite good actually. Well, now let's see how it's going to turn out if we've used some pattern paper on it. But first we have to decide what paper. So there are a few papers that I have in mind. And also I just want to try if I can use this, what's it called, burlap? Yeah, burlap. The English terms might be challenging for me sometimes, but so I'm also going to see if there is anything that fits with it. There's also a wood colored paper in here that might be nice on the spine, so let's just take a look at this collection. Well, this is the sticker sheet. So we have this course, and like this is what I like on the spine or the burlap. So I wanted to go with that. And I've also decided on, let me find that sheet. There are some cutter parts in here as well. These, and I think I am going to place this one. It's going to go underneath here. So it has to go with that as well. So I was thinking, this is my favorite. There's no place like home. Or welcome to our home. This has the lighter wood edge. This has darker wood edge. So maybe that goes together with this or this a little bit better. But I think the dark one will go with it fine as well. And this is my favorite actually. Also because when I place this one in here, I have a little bit more of that wood grain showing. But we'll see. I haven't decided 100%, but it's going to be one of those that's going to be in here. So this is one of my favorite. I also have some extras of it. So that's a really good option. And this one, I really like this one. So this is the darker flower. Let's get that out of the way. I know I'm going to use this card. So I'm going to use the darker flower, the light green flower, or this one. But I think this is just maybe just a little too plain. I think it's better to use it in the album for some. So this one, that's an option. I like it. Or this one. Oh, they're both good. They're both good. And I have to make the decision. So that one, that one. And I think, although I really like this one, but maybe we can do with something with it on the back, I am going for the lighter one because I just think it's a little bit more spring, vibrant, light. Yeah, let's go with this one. Whew, we made that decision. Well, I did. Okay, now I'm going to place this to the side. Put it all back. And then I have to measure the size of this piece. So I'm going for an inch. Why? I want to have an inch on all sides. Okay. I made a little boo-boo. I tried to place acetate on here, but I had to take it off using undo. Got damaged a little bit, that's fine. It's going to be on the back. As long as your inside is nice, then you will be good. So that's why it's a little bit rough now. I have my pattern paper and I'm going to turn it around. Make sure if it's directional that you have it in the right direction. I'm going to turn it around and this ugly looking bit is going looking up to me. So I have about an inch around the piece and I'm going to place this right here on top of that. So let's place some, yeah, I'm going to do some double-sided tape around the edges because that's going to help me. So I'm going to do that on the good looking side of this piece. Just placing it around the edges. And I'm going to combine my double-sided tape with my wet glue for this. And of course, you could also just cut a frame out your pattern paper and just stick it on here. Give it a quick burnish. And remove the tape backing. If you have sheets of double-sided tape, that might work as well on this project, I think. Then I would place the sheet of double-sided tape, I think, on the pattern paper. But this will work as well. Some in between. I just want to make sure everything stays where we want it to be. So again, before my glue dries. Check the direction of your paper. I'm turning it around. And I am placing this in a way where I am straight. So I'm using the grid on my cutting surface to help me with that. And I am just pushing it down. Because you want to have your pattern straight on there as well. So that might be something you want to take in consideration. So, I'm just giving it a quick burnish here.
gekocht.
And now we are going to, let me think. I think I'm going to start with scoring a little bit on my pattern paper before I fold it, because I don't want it to crack. Just going along the edges of the piece. This Cartabella paper is really sturdy cardstock, but you never know, you never know. So we do everything that we can to prevent it from cracking, especially after all this work. So now I'm going to fold on the outside just a little bit. And then we can, we have little squares here, folding, folding, and I'm going to cut that out. So it might be possible that you're able to see the corners a little bit. So maybe I should have done it with the green as well, but I've tried it in my tryout with cutting it at an angle, and that didn't turn out pretty as well. So because we have the height of the piece, so I think this is just the best way to go. And then we can fold on this, but we don't want to have any overhang on our edges, so we are going to slightly taper it as well to the inside. Don't have to go far, just a little bit. I'm just going to pre-fold this a little bit, and then I'm going to apply some double-sided tape. And you want to make sure that you don't go over your frame. So I'm going to apply double-sided tape on my edge of the frame, and also on my edges of the cardstock. Okay, I'm going to burnish the tape backing. And also, again, I'm just going to use my wet glue as well, and that most for on the edges. I'm going to start on the longer sides. It's just something that I do. I do that with my covers. I maybe because everybody does it, and that's just what you do always. And I'm going to remove these as well. So I am going a little bit slower, I think, with this. Just adding some wet glue here as well. Because I really want to do everything out again to not make this cardstock crack. Let's see what's the best way. Okay, that's one, and I will burnish the edges completely when I have done all my sides. We will go over and give it a good burnish everywhere. you have a little bit of a naked corner here, but I can live with it. I can live with it. It's not perfect, but. Okay, now I'm going to give everything a nice burnish. And I really think that it's placing those strips help in getting a nice edge now. Because sometimes your chipboard is a little bit longer than the post support that you have in the middle. So you just want that to be nice and even. Now we need to do this, of course. So I figured out that the best way, I've tried several ways, but the best way is just cut your cross and then cut these pieces a little shorter. So that's just what I'm going to do now. Thinking, do I have a smaller, you don't have to be precise actually, but this is just helping me with the angle a little bit. And my blade is so dull, I'm actually thinking about getting a second utility knife so I can use one on my chipboard stuff that's making the blades go dull pretty quick, and then one on my cardstock, because I am changing up these blades pretty fast, pretty often, that's what I should say. So this we can now fold in, but again I'm just going to place some double-sided tape. So let's cut this away a little bit. I can do that with my knife as well. I just want to have about an inch. You can eyeball it a little bit. Just make sure you have enough to go over the edge. Now I'm also placing some tape on those edges, just like I did on the outside. But I do have a lot of fun making it actually. I'm enjoying myself. That's the most important thing, right? Come on. There we go. I'm just removing it all so I can just go on. Just be careful with your knife when you're doing this. Okay, the wet glue. Okay, I'm going to start on the longer side again. Again, I'm just going to place some on this edge, and I'm going to put some over here. I'm just going for it. Now obviously I have tape showing here. That's not a big deal. But perhaps I could have placed a little less. You see how if you have glue showing here, that's what you should get rid of, actually, because you might be able to see that when you're done. Just going to fold all the edges over and then I'm going to give it a burnish. Last one. So that's it. It it's looking pretty good to me. So, I'm showing you on the back now. This one doesn't want to stay in place. Let's close this one quick. You will be able to see the cardstock showing there, but that's why we've used that green. And when you have it lying like this, it's not too bad. You can see it a little bit right there. It's hard for you to see on camera, but when you have your book lying in front of you, you are able to see it a little bit, but not too much. So the last thing that I'm going to do is place acetate right here. And like I said, I've tried it in an earlier stage, but that wasn't really smart because then I wasn't able to fold my patterned paper over anymore. So we've removed that. So let's see if I can still use this piece. I've used undo to get rid of it. And if you haven't heard of it before, if you don't know it, it's when you apply it, you lose your stickiness of the tape. But when it dries, your stickiness is back. So you have your stickiness again. Now I have some pieces here that are not sticky at the moment, and I don't think I'm going to worry about it because it's not going to be something that I'm going to really use actively. It's just now, applying it now, and then I'm not going to fuss around with it anymore once the album is done. So I don't think it's a big deal. If I would have used this piece in a pocket on my album, on my pages, then I would have tried to get rid of it or placed some new tape on there, because then I would have wanted that whole piece sticky. So now this is what we have, and then I am going to cut out that card, that 6x4 card. Let's see. So I'm going to cut it out and probably place it on some white, or I'm going to place it on here and then put some extra cardstock to keep it in place, or place this on some cardstock and place that on here to have a good stick to it. But that's going to be in there, and I like that one, but I'm not going to do it now because I still just I'm in doubt. And I also saw another one in the on the other sheet, so yeah, we'll see what I come up with. But I'm going to cut it out, make sure it fits and sticks on the back of it, and then that whole piece we can stick on top of our cover. I think this is a good stopping point for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you bear with me. It was the first time that I actually made it completely, so I think it went pretty well actually. So yeah, thank you for watching. Please give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Feel free to subscribe to my channel, and I hope to see you in the next video, and enjoy the rest of your day.